you see is violence in movies and sex on TV.
But where are those good old-fashioned values on which we used to rely?
I'm afraid of ghosts. And yes, Mr. Swanson has lost all movement and will require around-the-clock care, most of it disgusting.
So, he's a doctor. Best known for doing many things, such as entering Peter's anus and trying to turn him on while wearing women's clothing. Yep, that's their doctor. He is voiced by Seth MacFarlane, though, so that's a big plus. Anyways, Dr. Elmer can be really out of nowhere at times, but that's mainly where his humor comes from. He's not the best character on this list, but he can definitely have some great moments.
It seems today that all you see...
Stop! What the hell are you doing?
I've seen The Walking Dead! I have to destroy your brain and then talk about it for the next hour!
Well, Chris is probably the most likable character on the whole show, and we can all relate to him a lot. He's a fucking tub of lard who just wants a girlfriend. Don't we all? But anyways, he's got some good moments.
I guess it's worth a shot.
Of course it is. If she says yes, you'll surprise everyone, just like you did on New Year's Eve.
3, 2, 1!
Some animals give me boners!
And he's a good addition to the family. He also defends his annoying sister Meg from bullying. Like, my god, do you remember when him and Meg beat the shit out of their whole school? What a man.
It seems today that all you see...
Well, it's just me and my old nemesis. First step.
Hey, Joe, what you doing? You out for a walk?
I hate this block.
Joe has inspired loads of memes across the internet of Family Guy. He's a paralyzed wheelchair officer who gets picked on a lot for not being able to walk. He constantly sounds like that guy who would commentate all those Yo Mama joke videos. Do you guys remember when he had to re-paralyze himself?
Oh, my perfect ass!
Oh, I'm sorry, Joe. I was aiming for your spine.
Oh, damn it!
Joe, I'm so sorry. I'm a terrible shot.
Oh, for God's sakes, just give me the gun! I'll do it myself!
Ha! Imagine having legs that don't work. Moving on.
It seems today that all you see...
What the hell?
No, 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 no!
Hey, Peter, can you blow that towel rack down here? Thank you.
Cleveland's black. Enough said. He's an amazing character. Also, he has his own TV show, which is actually impressive. Like, out of all the characters to get a spinoff show, it was Cleveland. Not Joe, not Quagmire, but Cleveland. Wow. Also, yeah, he's black.
It seems today that all you see...
Hey, there's another note. Glenn, this is your child. Next time, wear a condom, jerk. Oh, that's the note from earlier. I need a file cabinet.
Well, 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 we have Quagmire. The horniest 61-year-old you could ever know. One of his best moments was, despite being one horny bastard, didn't know what porn was. And as soon as he found out, nobody saw him, until he came back with one jacked arm. Wonder how that happened. Anyways, Quagmire is a really funny character, and it's no surprise that he made the list.
It seems today that all you see...
Hey, Lois, what's going on here?
Oh, it's my book club, Peter. Come, join us.
Oh, okay!
Peter is the main character, and it's not really surprising. He's easily one of the funniest cartoon dads of all times. There's so many funny moments in Family Guy that come from just him. He's pretty charming, but he tries to take care for his family, which is cool. He's also naked a lot. Not sure why. That probably shouldn't have even been brought up. Oh well, fuck it, he likes being naked. Remember when Naked Brian attacked him? That was scary. I mean, if your dog got completely shaved like that, you would definitely be scared too. How did that even happen? I didn't watch the episode. Someone tell me in the comments how that happened. I'm genuinely curious.
It seems today that all you see...
There isn't many girls on this list. Oh, wait, that's because they aren't funny. Anyways, we have Stewie Griffin, the evil, twisted-minded baby. Yep, he's a baby. and the smartest in their family. Remember when Lois barfed on him? Man, that was ruthless. Stewie and Brian's friendship has always been a wholesome, funny bond on the show, and their episodes together are usually some of their best. Well, besides evil Stewie, but we don't talk about that. You know, out of all the characters in the Griffin family, Stewie is the least relatable. Probably because he's the smartest. Man, this generation's fucked.
It seems today that all you see is...
I just have a... Oh, God, I'm so sorry I keep doing that. Oh, God, please forgive me. I get that from my father. He's from a different generation. It's,
Whatever, man.
We cool? We good?
Yeah, we're cool. Fine.
Brian is the dog of the family, despite being able to talk full English. I don't know. His companion is Stewie most of the time. Like, he doesn't even hang around Peter, you know, the dad, but he hangs around the baby. But hey, they get along, sort of, so it's whatever. He seems to be pretty smart too, surprising for a dog, but hey, you never know. Your dog might be really smart too. Remember the episode where Brian and Stewie legalized marijuana by singing a 1 minute song? That was cool. But Brian and Stewie have had their troubles too. In the episode literally called Brian and Stewie, they get locked in a bank vault, and despite almost killing each other, they tuck out their differences and end the episode nicely. That was actually an episode that had no cutaway gags. Impressive! But yeah, Brian's a good character because he's a dog, and, a dog. Yeah, he's cool.
It seems today that all you see is...
But wait, the chicken has a name. It's not just the chicken. Yeah, shut the fuck up, it's the chicken. Anyways, this chicken is an ass-kicking machine, like, holy. I don't know where this fucker grew up, but goddamn can he throw. Anyways, imagine having this dude in Street Fighter. That would be so jokes. This chicken would most certainly fuck up Ryu within 3 easy seconds. Man, I wouldn't stand within at least 20 feet of this thing. He'd probably clap my cheeks and eat my food. Anyways, yeah, he's a chicken. Haha, funny random character. Haha, funny next. But before we get into our number one pick, here are some honorable mentions.
It seems today that all you see is violence in movies and sex on TV.
It's like girls are a different species or something.
Oh, who needs them? You like popsicles?
Well, sure.
And you need to come on down to the cellar. I got a whole freezer full of popsicles. Mmm. Stop it, Meg!
It seems today that all you see is violence in movies and sex on TV.
But where are those good old-fashioned values on which we used to rely? Lucky there's a Family Guy. Lucky there's a Family.
Hey, Lois, me make drive time to a super fun clam with Noble Quagmire and Wheel Monster Joe. Go, Force!
Wow, we got an amazing character on here. He was only in one episode for a 9-second gag, but it was the best 9 seconds of my whole life. It made viewers sob uncontrollably from the amazing character work of Anime Peter. I personally stan Anime Peter. Post in the comments if you guys stan Anime Peter too. Everyone should. He should win every award in the world. Fucking, let's make Anime Peter a city. Let's call it Anime Peterolipus. Wait, no. Let's make it a state. No, a country. Wait, Anime Peter should be a planet. He needs to be honored, is what I'm saying. Give him the support he needs.
It seems today that all you see is violence in movies and sex on TV.
But where are those good old-fashioned values on which we used to rely?